Want to speak real Portuguese from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at PortuguesePod101.com.
Top 10 phrases your parents always say. Toma cuidado, viu? Be careful, will you? View means, did you see, did you see it? We use it a lot in Portuguese. You can say, view, toma cuidado. See, take care, ou be careful. Or, toma cuidado, viu? Be careful, see? You can also use view to call someone's attention. View, você vem amanhã? See, are you coming tomorrow? It sounds strange in English, but that's how we say it in Portuguese. It would be, hey, are you coming tomorrow? Fica quieto. Be quiet. Usually moms use this phrase when they are very angry and their children won't shut up. They just say, fica quieto, menino. Be quiet, boy. Comporte-se. Behave. Comporte-se. Behave. My mom used to say me this phrase a lot, especially when I was going to someone else's home or on vacations to a place with friends. Yeah, they always say, comporte-se, hein? Behave, okay? Faz a sua lição de casa. Do your homework. Do your homework. Faz a sua lição de casa. I was a very good student when I was little, so my mom didn't have to ask me to do my homework. But at night she would just come and say, você fez a sua lição de casa? Did you do your homework? Hora de dormir. Time to sleep. Time to sleep. Hora de dormir. When you go to sleep, in Portuguese we don't have good evening and good night. We say both boa noite. So you can just say boa noite, mãe. Boa noite, pai. Good night, mom. Good night, dad. Eu vou contar até três. I'm going to count to three. I'm going to count to three. Eu vou contar até três. Yeah, so this is the scariest sentence your parents can tell you. You don't actually want to know what will happen after the three, so you just better behave. Comporte-se, okay? Para com isso. Stop that. Stop that. Para com isso. Another funny thing is that if your parents tell you something much slower, that would be much more scary. So if they say, para com isso, it's just like, stop that. But if they say, para com isso, you'd be like, okay, I won't move anymore. O que foi que você falou? What did you say? What did you say? O que foi que você falou? This phrase can be used in two situations. One is when you say something bad, like a bad word, or you complain about something your mom or dad did, and they will be, o que foi que você falou? But if you just say something and they don't understand it, they can also say, o que foi que você falou? But they're just asking, what did you say? I couldn't understand what he said. Eu não tô brincando. I'm not kidding. I'm not kidding. Eu não tô brincando. So your parents could tell you, I'm not kidding, eu não tô brincando. Or, eu tô falando sério. I'm being serious, I'm saying it seriously. And you also have the opposite. Eu tô brincando, I'm kidding. That you can also use that sentence. Desliga a TV agora. Turn the TV off now. Turn the TV off now. Desliga a TV agora. If you didn't do your homework or it's time to sleep, your mom or dad might say to you, desliga a TV agora e vai estudar. Turn off the TV now and go study. 20 travel phrases you should know. Travel, viajar. Você pode me ver um mapa? Could you get me a map? Você pode me ver um mapa? Could you get me a map? Well, nowadays everyone has cell phone and we have maps on it, so it's not that useful anymore. But sometimes in some smaller cities, it's very useful to have a map. So just remember the word, mapa. It's not that hard, right? Você fala inglês? Do you speak English? Você fala inglês? Do you speak English? Well, this is kind of a survival phrase, especially if you don't speak Portuguese very well. You should know that one. So you can, you know, just approach everyone and just ask them, você fala inglês? Você fala inglês? Well, if you speak another language, you can also ask, just change English for that language, right? Você fala inglês? Você fala francês? Você fala japonês? And hopefully someone will speak the language you need. Tem algum ônibus que vai do aeroporto até a cidade? Is there a bus from the airport to the city? Tem algum ônibus que vai do aeroporto até a cidade? Is there a bus from the airport to the city? In most airports, there will probably be a bus that goes from the airport to the city, so just ask information or guardinha, like a security guard. Yeah, we love to ask the guardinhas. Moço! Excuse me, sir. Moço, com licença. Wi-Fi é gratuito? Is the Wi-Fi free? O Wi-Fi é gratuito? Is the Wi-Fi free? You can also say, o Wi-Fi é grátis? In most restaurants, hotels, and everywhere you go, they will have a Wi-Fi. So sometimes the Wi-Fi is free, but they still have a password. So you can ask, qual é a senha do Wi-Fi? What is the Wi-Fi password? Você tem quarto vago para hoje? Do you have any vacancies tonight? Você tem quarto vago para hoje? Do you have any vacancies tonight? I prefer to book for a room before going to the city, but many people prefer to just go to the place they want to go and there they find the hotel. Well, if you do that, then you have to ask, tem algum quarto para hoje à noite? Or tem algum quarto vago para hoje à noite? Eu poderia me mudar para outro quarto? Could I move to a different room? Eu poderia me mudar para outro quarto? Could I move to a different room? Well, there are many reasons why you want to change a room. Maybe it's too noisy, barulhento. Or something's broken, quebrado. So you can just go complain, this is broken, or it's too noisy. Posso me mudar para outro quarto? Eu tenho uma reserva. I have a reservation. Eu tenho uma reserva. I have a reservation. Well, you can use this at hotels or restaurants. If you want to be more specific, you can say, eu tenho uma reserva no nome de. I have a reservation under the name of. Eu tenho uma reserva no nome de Paloma. Você pode trazer o cardápio, por favor? Could you bring the menu, please? Você pode trazer o cardápio, por favor? Could you bring the menu, please? Okay, this is very useful because many countries, they also use the word menu, similar to the English. But in Brazil, we mostly use the word cardápio. So don't forget it. If you say menu, they probably understand, but it's much more common to say cardápio. Você tem alguma sugestão? Do you have any recommendations? Você tem alguma sugestão? Do you have any recommendations? So you can ask that to the waiter, the waitress, or maybe the tour guide. You can also say like, I like meat. Do you have any recommendations? Eu gosto de carne. Você tem alguma sugestão? Você pode trazer a conta? Could I have the check? Você pode trazer a conta? Can I have the check? So, você pode trazer a conta literally means, can you bring me the bill? But, well, in English it's more common to say, can I have the check, maybe? You can also say just, a conta, por favor, the check, please. Eu sou alérgico a amendoim. I'm allergic to peanuts. Eu sou alérgico a amendoim. I'm allergic to peanuts. I'm so lucky I'm not allergic to anything, so I can just order whatever I want. Maybe I won't like it, but at least it won't be bad for me. If you're allergic to something, make sure to know that word in Portuguese. If you don't know that word, you can just post in the comments below and we'll make sure to answer you. Uma água, por favor. Water, please. Uma água, por favor. Water, please. Usually when you order water in Brazil, they come in bottles, they don't come in glasses. And they are usually água mineral, not água com gás, which would be sparkling water. So if you just want normal, natural water, you can just say água mineral. Quanto custa este daqui? How much is this? Quanto custa este daqui? How much is this? So if you're in store looking at things, you can just say, oh, I like that one. Quanto custa este daqui? How much is this? Eu quero 10 desses. I'd like 10 of these. Eu quero 10 desses. I'd like 10 of these. So if you went to the store and you asked, quanto custa este daqui? And you liked it, you can just say, eu vou levar 10 desses. I'm gonna take 10 of these. Eu quero este daqui. I'd like this one. Eu quero este daqui. I'd like this one. If you want to be very specific, you can say, eu quero este daqui. I'd like this one. If you want that one, you would say, eu quero aquele dali. Tem desconto? Is there a discount? Tem desconto? Is there a discount? So it's very common to ask for discounts in Brazil. You can also say, tem desconto no dinheiro? Is there a discount in cash? Especially if you're buying a lot of merchandise, you can ask that. Of course, you're not gonna ask in a supermarket or a chain store, but if it's like a local business, it's more common to give a discount. Maybe in touristic areas, not that common, but well, you should try, right? As we say in Brazil, não custa nada. Doesn't cost anything. At the most, your answer is gonna be no, no, não tem desconto. Vocês aceitam cartão de crédito? Do you take credit card? Vocês aceitam cartão de crédito? Do you take credit card? Nowadays, you can pay by credit card everywhere. It's very, very hard to find a place that doesn't accept credit card. Like, it's crazy. Even if you go, for example, to the beach, there's like the guy selling earrings and he's gonna have his credit card machine so you can pay with credit card. I'm not kidding. Yeah. Onde fica a rodoviária? Where's the bus terminal? Onde fica a rodoviária? Where's the bus terminal? You can say rodoviária or terminal rodoviário, but it's much more common just to say rodoviária. Quanto é a passagem? What's the fare? Quanto é a passagem? What's the fare? You can use the question at the rodoviária, the bus terminal, for example, for a long distance bus, but you can also use it for a local bus. For example, if you don't see the price that is usually in the front of the bus, you can just ask the driver, motorista, or cobrador, você poderia parar em, or você poderia me avisar? But first you have to ask, quanto é a passagem? Quanto é a tarifa? Você pode tirar uma foto de mim, por favor? Could you take a picture of me, please? Você pode tirar uma foto de mim, por favor? Can you take a picture of me, please? Most people nowadays don't leave their home without their selfie stick, which in Portuguese is pau de selfie. But if you don't have your pau de selfie, you can just ask someone. Você pode tirar uma foto de mim, por favor? Or, você pode tirar uma foto de nós, por favor? Can you take our picture, please? Yeah, I'm talking with my ghost friend here.
Want to speak real Portuguese from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at PortuguesePod101.com.
Top 10 phrases you always want to hear. Você ganhou. You won. So especially if it's a big prize, like a lottery, you always want to hear this phrase, right? For example, você ganhou a loteria. You won the lottery. Estou com saudades de você. I miss you. Especially for people that travel a lot, this is a common phrase to hear. When you're in your big travel, your family might call you and say, ai, que bom que você ligou. Eu estava com saudades de você. Oh, that's so good that you called. I was missing you. Eu trouxe uma coisinha para você. I brought you something. Who doesn't like presents? So when your friend comes back from traveling, he might bring you a gift or a souvenir and say, eu trouxe uma coisinha para você. I brought you something. O orçamento é ilimitado. The budget is unlimited. So maybe at your work, your boss might tell you, o orçamento é ilimitado para a festa. The budget is unlimited to the party. So you can be a big party with all your friends and all family from everyone in your company. Vai ter bônus no final do mês. There will be a bonus at the end of the month. Yeah, money is always good, right? So if your boss comes to you and tells you, vai ter bônus, you might be prepared because there's a bonus coming up.
vai ter um bônus no final do mês. There will be a bonus at the end of the month. Você é um cozinheiro excelente. You're an excellent cook. Compliments are always good, so if someone tells you você é um excelente something, it means that you're excellent at something. So, você é um excelente cozinheiro. You're an excellent cook. Você é uma excelente cantora. You're an excellent singer. Você está ótimo hoje. You look great today. Especially for women, we go and we put makeup and we brush our hair and we do a lot of things and no one says anything. So guys, just be nice to girls and say, você está ótima hoje. You look great today. Você estava certo. You were right. If you have a discussion with someone and he's always telling you, no, you're wrong, I'm wrong. And then he finally figures out that, no, he was wrong and you're the right person, he might tell you, você estava certo. Yeah, you were right. Você fez ótimo trabalho. You did a great job. So your boss at work or your teacher at school might tell you, você fez ótimo trabalho. You did a great job. Você pode descansar. Eu vou fazer a faxina hoje. Take a break. I'll do the cleaning today. Yeah, that's a good one, right? I don't think many people like to do cleaning. I don't. But if someone comes to you and say, você pode descansar. You can take a break. Eu vou fazer a faxina hoje. I'll do the cleaning today. Yeah, that's a good one. Yeah, I allow someone to do that for me.
Top 10 phrases you need for a date. Um encontro. A date. Você gostaria de sair para jantar comigo? Would you like to go out to dinner with me? You can also just say, você gostaria de jantar comigo? Would you like to have dinner with me? The answers could be, claro, of course, or, desculpa, estou ocupada. I'm sorry, I'm busy. Você está livre neste fim de semana? Are you free this weekend? This phrase doesn't have any romantic meaning, so you can also just ask your friend or your co-worker. Você está livre neste fim de semana? Are you free this weekend? Você gostaria de sair comigo? Would you like to hang out with me? Sair means to leave, but if you say sair com alguém, that would mean to go out or to hang out with someone. Você gostaria de sair comigo? Would you like to hang out or to go out with me? Quer ir ao cinema comigo hoje à noite? Would you like to go to the movies with me tonight? Here, since we are using the verb querer, to want, the answer would be eu quero or eu não quero. I want or I don't want. Você está linda. You look beautiful. You can also say você é linda. You are beautiful. But if you just want to compliment a woman because of her outfit, you'd say você está linda. Posso te ligar amanhã? Can I call you tomorrow? Well, nowadays, people don't really call anymore. They just send a WhatsApp. Um WhatsApp. Or, as most people say in Brazil, um zap zap. Posso te mandar um WhatsApp amanhã? Can I send you a WhatsApp tomorrow? There would be a WhatsApp message. Eu te levo para casa. I will drive you home. Eu te levo para casa actually means I will take you home. But you can kind of understand that the person taking you home will probably take you home by car. Or by motorcycle, I don't know. Or by bike. Yeah. A que horas a gente se encontra amanhã? What time shall we meet tomorrow? Lá pelas 6. Around 6. Or não muito cedo. Not too early. A gente pode se encontrar de novo? Can we meet again? So if you really like the person and you think your date is going great, you can just ask her or him. A gente pode se ver de novo? Can we meet again? Quer ir para outro lugar? Shall we go somewhere else? If your date is looking bored, you can say, você quer ir para outro lugar? Shall we go somewhere else? Do you want to go somewhere else? But be careful because they might just be bored because of you. I hope not, but, well. If they say, ai, que eu tenho que voltar para casa. Oh, is that I need to go back home? That might mean that the person is not very happy around you. I'm sorry.
Top 10 phrases to amaze native speakers. Além do português, eu também sei outras línguas. Apart from Portuguese, I can speak other languages as well. If you say this phrase in Brazil, people will be so jealous at you because many Brazilians can't even speak English. So if you just say, eu posso falar outras línguas também,
I can speak other languages as well. They'll be like, okay, he's a genius. Ele é um gênio. Além do português, eu também falo inglês, francês e espanhol. Apart from Portuguese, I can also speak English, French and Spanish. Especially for people that can speak Portuguese, Spanish, even French and Italian are very easy. Not very easy, but easier to learn. Estou aprendendo português sozinho. I'm learning Portuguese by myself. I think it's a pretty amazing sentence to say because people usually go to language schools in Brazil to learn English and Spanish usually. But if you just say, you know, I'm learning that by myself, they will be like, wow. Não, eu não vou para a escola. Eu estou aprendendo português sozinho. No, I don't go to school. I'm learning Portuguese by myself. Estou estudando português faz 10 anos. I've been learning Portuguese for 10 years. That's a pretty long, hard-working path, right? Eu sei português porque eu estou aprendendo português faz 10 anos. I know Portuguese because I've been learning Portuguese for 10 years. Eu entendi tudinho que você disse. I completely understood everything you said. Using diminutives in Portuguese sentence shows that you can, you know, play with the language, so it seems like you're fluent in the language. If you say tudinho, that means small everything. Sounds like very Portuguese, very Brazilian. Não precisa repetir. Eu entendi tudinho que você me disse. You don't need to repeat. I completely understood what you said. Eu consigo assistir filmes em português sem legendas. I can watch movies in Portuguese without subtitles. Famous Brazilian movies you should watch are City of God, Cidade de Deus, or Tropa de Elite, The Elite Squad, which are all-time famous movies in here. Não precisa se preocupar. Eu consigo assistir filmes em português sem legenda. You don't need to worry. I can watch movies in Portuguese without subtitles. Levou apenas um ano para me tornar fluente. It took me only 1 year to become fluent. I think if you're a native Spanish speaker, you might say levou apenas um ano. But if you're an English speaker, it might take a little longer if you don't dedicate, you know, all your time to learn Portuguese. If someone tells you, wow, seu português é ótimo. Wow, your Portuguese is great. You can answer, não, não é nada. Levou apenas um ano para me tornar fluente. No, it's nothing. It took me only 1 year to become fluent. Obrigada, mas na verdade eu não sou brasileira. Thank you, but I'm not Brazilian, actually. Yeah, I think that's the most amazing phrase you want to hear. Nossa, eu achei que você fosse brasileira. Wow, I thought you were Brazilian. Obrigada, mas na verdade eu não sou brasileira. Thank you, but actually I'm not Brazilian. Português é divertido e fácil de aprender. Portuguese is fun and easy to learn. If you tell this phrase to your friends, I think they'll be amazed because we know Portuguese is not that easy. And you just say, não, não é difícil. Português é divertido e fácil de aprender. No, it's not hard. Portuguese is fun and easy to learn. Posso memorizar umas 50 palavras novas por dia em português. I can memorize around 50 new Portuguese words a day. Yeah, that's pretty amazing. Usually people can memorize 10 to 20 words a day, but if you say you can memorize 50, they'll be like, wow. Another word for memorize would be decorar, to know by heart. Você pode me ensinar mais. Eu posso decorar umas 50 palavras por dia em português. You can teach me more. I can memorize around 50 new words a day in Portuguese. Vou falar português como falante nativo em 3 anos. I'll speak Portuguese like a native speaker in 3 years. That's a bold challenge, but if you're up to it, I think that's totally doable to learn and to be fluent in a language in 3 years. Eu vou estudar muito e vou falar português como nativo em 3 anos. I'll study a lot and I'll speak Portuguese as a native speaker in 3 years. Top 15 questions you should know. De onde você é? Where are you from? So when you arrive in Brazil, the first person to see is going to ask you, de onde você é? Where are you from? So you can answer it by saying, eu sou de, or eu sou dos, or sou da. If you're from Mexico, you can say, eu sou do México. You just need to be careful with the de preposition in Portuguese, because we also use a article together with it. So it can be de, or dos, or da, or das, okay? O que foi que você falou? What did you say? So if someone is talking to you, you're not really listening to him, you can just say, o que foi que você falou? What did you say? Eu não falei nada. I didn't say anything. Eu falei que eu te amo. I told I love you. Pay attention to what people are saying. Onde fica o banheiro? Where's the bathroom? Every restaurant has to have a bathroom in Brazil, so you can just ask him, onde fica o banheiro? But you can also use the sentence if you're visiting someone and you need to use the restroom, it's okay. Onde fica o banheiro? Fica ali no fundo do corredor. It's at the end of the corridor. Onde você mora? Where do you live? You're gonna use this sentence a lot and people are gonna ask you too. They can say, de onde você é? Where are you from? But they can also say, onde você mora? Meaning, where do you live? Eu moro em São Paulo. I live in São Paulo. Eu moro no México. I live in Mexico. Onde você trabalha? Where do you work? Brazilians are very curious and they might ask you a lot of questions. One of them might be, onde você trabalha? Where do you work? Eu trabalho na Paulista. I work at Paulista Avenue, which is a very famous avenue in São Paulo. Eu trabalho na Petrobras. I work at Petrobras, a very famous Brazilian company. Qual é o seu nome? What's your name? This is the first question they're gonna ask you. Meu nome é? My name is? Or you can just say your name. Paloma. Qual é o seu número de telefone? What's your phone number? They might say, qual é o seu número de telefone? Or, qual é o seu telefone? What is your phone? But meaning, phone number. O meu telefone é 947777767. Brazilian cell phones always start with a 9 at the beginning. Quantos anos você tem? How old are you? When people ask you how old you are, you can say, eu tenho 20 anos. I am 20 years old. O que é isso? What's this? In Portuguese, we use a lot of que in sentences. For example, here, it's very common to repeat the que. O que é isso? What's this? É telefone. It's a phone. É uma câmera. It's a camera. Tudo bem? How are you? You can answer tudo bem question with the same. Tudo bem. I'm fine. Or, não muito bem. Not very well. Faz quanto tempo que você está estudando português? How long have you been studying Portuguese? If you're speaking a lot of Portuguese, for sure people are gonna ask you, faz quanto tempo que você estuda português? How long have you been studying Portuguese? Faz só mês. Only a month. Or, já fazem 5 anos. It's already 5 years. Wow, seu português é perfeito. Wow, your Portuguese is perfect. Onde você aprendeu português? Where did you learn Portuguese? Eu aprendi na escola. I learned at school. Eu aprendi com os meus pais. I learned with my parents. Eu aprendi assistindo filmes. I learned watching movies. Quando é o seu aniversário? When is your birthday? We really like to celebrate birthdays in Brazil. Some people may ask you, quando é o seu aniversário? When is your birthday? É dia 15 de outubro. It's on October 15th. Você gosta de comida brasileira? Do you like Brazilian food? Brazilians are very meaty people. They really like meat, so most of the dishes have a lot of meat on it. If you like meat, you can say sim, e principalmente a feijoada. Yes, especially feijoada. Or, não muito, eu prefiro comida japonesa. Not that much. I prefer Japanese food. Você já foi para o Brasil? Have you ever been to Brazil? If you can speak Portuguese, my people may ask you, você já foi para o Brasil? Have you been to Brazil? You can say, já umas 5 vezes. Yes, maybe 5 times. Or, não, eu nunca fui. No, I've never been.